It's more than 100 years since the Anzacs travelled by ship to meet their fate at Gallipoli, but the Turkey of today is very different, and a new group of Australians are back there creating history, helping to build the world's longest suspension bridge linking Turkey's east and west.
It's a part of the world that inspires strong emotions for Australians, where our young men fought, died and forged a national identity. But Australians now visit a very different Gallipoli in a modern Turkey, and an Australian company, the Men from Mars, is forging new links, part of a team building the world's longest suspension bridge.
For us to be involved in that project, building a bridge from Gallipoli is just, it's amazing.
The bridge will link the Gallipoli Peninsula in Turkey's east to its west, starting on the coast opposite Anzac Cove. It will join the town of Gallipoli to the town of Lipseki, now either 40 minutes on a ferry or several hours by car. That bridge will span 4.5 kilometres, an unprecedented engineering feat requiring two of Mars' heavy lift tower cranes now in place. They are the world's largest, each weighing more than an A380 aircraft, and for good reason.
One of the lifts we're going to complete at the end of the project will be the highest and heaviest lift ever done by a crane.
Started 90 years ago, Mars helped construct everything from the Sydney Opera House to the Crown Casino at Barangaroo, the new Sydney Metro, along with projects across the globe. But the 1915 Çanakkale Bridge presents special challenges.
So we're working over water, which is always difficult. It's an earthquake zone, which is difficult, and it suffers extremely high winds.
A reason, no doubt, this band of Aussies is now using their skills in this special part of the world. Eddie Meyer, Nine News.